On February 11, 2020, the WHO announced COVID-19 as the name of the new disease spreading at an alarming rate throughout the world. COVID-19 is an infectious respiratory disease caused by a novel strain of coronavirus called SARS COV-2, which stands for Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus-2. It is closely related to the virus which caused the 2002 outbreak of Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, which was called SARS COV. Coronaviruses are more common than you expect and cause around 20% of all common cold cases in the US. SARS-CoV-2 is a novel strain of this category of viruses. COVID-19 symptoms can be confused with the common cold and include cough, fever, shortness of breath, pressure in the chest, muscle aches, etc. SARS-CoV-2 enters the human body through the respiratory pathway. It attaches to the cells of the lungs using its S-spike protein to the human angiotensin receptor on the surface of the cell. Then, it fuses with the cell membrane, releasing the viral RNA, the genetic material, inside the cell. It then takes control of the host cell machinery and produces proteins and more RNA to replicate itself. This triggers the immune response of the body, which sends white blood cells, macrophages, dendritic cells, and neutrophils to fight off the infection in the lungs. The white blood cells produce cytokines, chemical messengers which call more white blood cells. The virus affects the white blood cells' ability to fight off the infection, sending the immune system into overdrive. This causes more white blood cells to attack the virus, but the lung cells are caught in the crossfire. This leads to fibrosis and diffuse alveolar damage. It has been reported that recovered patients were left with 20-30% reduced lung function. However, there's no need to panic as all of these risks can simply be avoided by taking the following precautions. Washing hands regularly with soap and water helps to kill the virus that may be present on your hands. When you wash your hands with soap and water, you surround any microorganism on your skin with soap molecules. The hydrophobic tails of the free-floating soap molecules attempt to evade the water. In the process, they wedge themselves into the lipid envelopes of certain microbes and viruses, prying them apart. Sort of like crowbars. Practice social distancing and avoid touching your eyes, nose and the mouth. Maintaining a respiratory hygiene by covering your mouth and nose while coughing or sneezing restricts the spread of the virus and protects the people around you. In case of a fever, cough or difficulty in breathing, seek medical assistance as soon as possible. Stay home and avoid contact with others. Act responsibly, spread awareness and keep yourself and your surroundings safe.